I'm going to use this vegetable tan topsole to show you how to make the loop sandal and the sandal that originated with the Tumuamara Indians in northern Mexico, the ones that run great distances either barefoot or with very simple sandals. Here's an example of a loop sandal. So this one has 5 loops on it. You also can do them with just 3 loops, the toe loop and the ones back here. But what's nice about these sandals is that you can change the strap very easily. So I can pull this out and put in another strap. Here's an example of another one that's has a piece of cord through the loops, and this one has the same nylon cord, which is the strongest thing to use, I think. I had my husband, who's really strong, pull at all different kinds of leather, and in almost any case he could snap them, but this nylon braided cord he could not pull it apart. So that's what I like to use for these loops. And so it can be cloth, silk, braided cord, whatever you want to put through the loops to change the whole look of your sandal, you can do it. I'm going to show you how to make the Tumuamara sandal first, because it takes just one punch in each of these areas. And then I'll add the second punch in each of them to show you how to do the loop sandal. So I'm using a drive punch here. I'm making sure that back here in this area that I'm 3/8 of an inch from the edge. I'll use a piece of this folded over leather, folded over and stitched leather that you can get from Ohio Travel Bag. So if you want, you would use something, I think, a little more crude than this for making one of these. Although, it's a great sandal. Dressing it up, I think it has, there's no problem. It really is just an amazing sandal, the most minimalist sandal that you could possibly make. So you go down through, so I've gone in through this hole, and I'm just going to catch the end of this up here when I stitch, and then down through this hole where it gets looped around. Then it comes back here to make a heel loop, and down in this hole. So after you've done this, you're really ready to cement a sole on here. I'm going to use this rubber tire flooring. So I'll make a sole so I have the ends of the strap sandwiched in between here, and then I'll show you how the sandal gets tied. So I need to have it through those 3 holes, and then this loop made, and then I'm just about finished. Here's how the Tumuamara sandal with just one strap works. If I want a heel strap, and I'll put my foot up here and bring that around my heel, and then I've got this piece that I'm going to tie off in a half hitch. I can either do it there, I can bring it back and back again. By half hitch, I mean that I'll tuck this under the strap and make sure I've got it pulled tight. And cut that off wherever it works best. I could fasten this back here around the heel strap and have a sandal that looks more like that. Or I could not use the heel strap. Put that over the instep and then have a sandal that I can easily slip on or off and put my half hitch here. This sandal, you can also take this piece and wrap it around your ankle, just according to how long your thong is. This is how you transform the last sandal that you saw into the loop sandal. So you can see I've got these sets of holes. I could have another set right here. There are marks for them on your pattern. So I'm going to take, this is the same stitched cord. But again, you can use that nylon braid too. I mean, this is not going to, my husband could not rip this off. But it might be, you have to check and see how comfortable that is back against your ankle, whether this loop rubs, and it depends on how big you make your loops. You can figure that out. So I'm taking one end here, got that pulled through the loop, and the other end, of course I'd figure this out so I wouldn't be wasting all the excess, and then I'll go down to here, make another loop. And I just finished these off by laying these underfoot across and having these ends stick out. And then you can cut these off later, but these will be caught in the stitching as you go around the sole, attaching the upper sole to the bottom sole. And then you can make your straps any way that you want, a variety of colors. As I said, silk is really nice, sari silk. The cement on the bottom sole is dry, as well as cement on the upper sole. So I'll put them together, cut out the bottom sole to match the upper sole. Get my loops the same size. And then once I get that done, I will show you how you can sand the edge if you want to. Then I'll show you how to sand and buff the edge to give a little more finished look. Here's my loop sandal. Both the upper and the bottom sole had cement on it that is now dry. So I'll put them together. Right, did put them together, and I'll cut off the the soling. I'll be sanding this after I'm done, so that's when I'll deal with the with this piece. I'll cut it off and sand. So that sanding will, stitching will be the next step. So I'll do the usual making a mark with the wing dividers, punching holes around the edge, stitching, and then I'll be ready to sand and buff the edges. This is a belt sander, one that is very useful in making your sandals look good. If you want to even off the edge here, then a belt sander is the best way to do that. So I'll show you the process. I have them pretty much evened up, and the last thing I would like to do is to apply some beeswax and buff the vegetable tan leather, and then we'll be finished.